Well, it's not every day that a department store and its owners are the featured historical attraction in a local museum, but Birke's department store in Lowell is an exception. And if you're not sure why, pay close attention to our next story. Birke's department store in Lowell, opened more than 40 years ago by Nathan Birke and his wife Sally, this discount clothing store is part of the historic fabric of the city, an institution famous for its low-priced quality merchandise and infamous because of the cantankerous and downright rude treatment that Nathan Birke used to dish out to his customers.
Nathan was tough, very, very, you had to know him, honest as they make him. A real individual, a rugged, I have rarely met anybody as tough or as rugged as Nathan was, but honest.
Birke's was definitely not for the meek. You know, you couldn't be meek and shop there, but if you had chutzpah and you were able to sort of put him in his place, and then you just sort of shrugged and kept going.
Shifra Birke is Nathan's daughter, and today she is putting the finishing touches on, of all things, an exhibit of memorabilia from Birke's department store and from her parents' family albums, items that, for the most part, date after 1939, when Nathan, then in his 30s, and Sally, who was in her late teens, fled their native Poland ahead of the German invasion and began an odyssey that eventually landed them penniless in America in 1946.
This exhibit picks up, if you will, where Schindler's List leaves off. What happened to people who survived, and whether it was surviving Schindler's List by way of Schindler's List or surviving the way that my parents did, which was to spend 5.5 years in Russia during the war. These people lost the whole rest of their families, and you know, how do you go forward? So I think that's the reason for the exhibit, in addition to the fact that Lowell and the surrounding communities were really sort of struck by Birke's, by Nathan and by Sally, and I wanted to fill in the gaps and have them, you know, laugh and cry and understand.
Nathan Birke died in 1992 at the age of 84. His wife Sally, now 73, a resident of Chelmsford, still runs the family store on Market Street in Lowell. Do you miss Nathan?
Well, you live with a guy for 52 years, good or bad, you miss him.
Mm-hmm.
Of course you do.
For Sally, this exhibit on Birke's, which opens at the Mogan Cultural Center in Lowell this Saturday, is as much a personal gift as it is a historical collection. A show of appreciation from a loving child to her much beloved parents.
I've always wanted to, you know, pay homage, if you will, to all of the family who was killed, and also to honor my parents' survivorship, or whatever word we'd use, because I think it takes incredible people, despite all of the negatives about my father, and he was a very difficult father to have, and so I don't want to downplay that, but coexisting with that was incredible admiration on my part for his ability to make a life for this entire family, having had his family branch just snapped right off.
Now, a special opening reception for the Birke's exhibit will be held from 2 to 4 p.m. at the Mogan Center on Saturday. The exhibit will be there through the end of August.